Australia's openers emerged into the gloom at Canterbury on the third day of the Women's Ashes Test, hoping to stretch their first innings lead of 106. Having been bowled out for just 168 at the end of day two, England knew they needed quick wickets to haul themselves back into contention. And they got their dream start thanks to Katherine Brunt, who removed Elise Villani with the fifth ball of the morning, a peach that jagged back in and uprooted the off stump. And in Brunt's next over, the prized wicket of Australia captain Meg Lanning, who was also out for a duck after being trapped plumb in front. But just as the momentum and the ball was swinging in England's favour, the weather closed in. Umpires Alex Wharf and Neil Mallander checked the light and took the players off. Within moments, the heavens had opened and 4 hours of play were lost. When they resumed at 3:45, Elise Perry succumbed for 13, under-edging Anya Shrubsole through to Sarah Taylor, Australia 19 for 3. Nicole Bolton ground out 25, but just as she looked settled, she chipped Kate Cross to extra cover. Jess Jonathan, who made 99 in the first innings, showed some intent again on her test debut, while England thought they had Alex Blackwell caught at slip, only for the umpires to overturn it on review, adjudging it to have been grounded. Jonathan continued to look in impressive form as she launched the first six of the match off Laura Marsh, and Blackwell made the most of her extra life, shaking off the shackles with a rare lofted shot for four. But at 5:45, the rain returned, the covers were brought on, and stumps were drawn. Australia will resume the final day on 90 for four. That's a lead of 196. Blackwell and Jonathan well set as the not-out overnight batsmen.